الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى في قرآنه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ومن يؤمن بالله يهدي قلبه. الله عز وجل saying in this ayah, whoever believes in Allah, Allah will guide his heart. Whoever believes in Allah, no fear from anything. Then he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, guiding us how to have this hidayah. And I'm coming with how many kind of hidayah. قال عز وجل: ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. Surely with the ذكر of Allah, remembrance of Allah, by any way, reading Quran or saying tasbih or praying or doing sitting in halaqat of the learning, the knowledge, the Islamic knowledge, your heart will get rest. Your heart will get tranquility. Your heart will get the guidance, the hidayah. But who will give it to you? Allah. Allah said that also. هو الذي أنزل السكينة على رسوله وعلى المؤمنين. Allah is the one who will send that sakina upon the heart of the believers. And this is will happen if Allah knows that there is any goodness in your heart. Any little goodness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase it. إِنْ يَعْلَمِ اللَّهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ خَيْرًا يُؤْتِكُمْ خَيْرًا. If Allah knows any goodness in your heart, will give you goodness. And he teach us to do the dua. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. This is dua. Oh Allah, do not let our heart go astray after you guide us. And at the day of judgment, which it is the title of my khutab, serious khutab this day, that Allah Azza wa Jal say, day of judgment, there is no any money, there is no anything will benefit you. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except who come in front of Allah with a pure heart. Salim heart, good heart, clean. Clean from what? This is makhubba today. لسلامت القلب شروط. There is a condition for a pure heart. Even I already explained before, in order to know, the word heart, قلب, mentioned in the Quran 122 times. In the Quran, the word قلب, which it is the meaning of it, heart, mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem. Why Allah mentioned it 122, the roots and the branches, mushtaqat, 122 times. With another name, Fu'ad, because Fu'ad also means heart. Qalb or Fu'ad, Allah mentioned it 5 times. Means total 127 times in the Quran al-Kareem. But for that heart to be clean, I give you the summary you said before in the khutbah. There is a condition, there is some things in order to have it. Number one, سلامته من الشرك. Salim, pure, clean from shirk. This is number one to be having a pure heart, a clean heart, Salim will benefit you in front of Allah Azza wa Jal. Because Allah said in Surah An-Nisa, ayah number 48, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. Allah will never ever forgive shirk, and He will forgive it to whom He will, subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that to come in front of Allah with a pure heart, with a clean heart, clean from shirk, pure from any kind of associating with Allah Azza wa Jal, any partner. النَّافِعُ هُوَ answer me. Allah Azza wa Jal. وَالضَّارُّ هُوَ ومزيل الضرر هو then no fear from nobody. Circumstances is day so much going on here and there and the airport and fear and no. Everything in hand of Allah Azza wa Jal, but if your heart is saved, if your heart is connected to Allah, then you will not fear except Allah, whatever Allah write will happen. I am not saying sleep and saying no. You should know your right and you should do the right. You should know the right and you should do the right. But at the same time, put your heart in hand of Allah Azza wa Jal. Don't fear anybody except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is, will help you a lot. But fear and scare and this and that, it will never benefit you. Let us go on. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Az-Zumar, Surah number 39, ayah number 65,
وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ.
Already revealed not only to Rasulullah. Allah saying this ayah to Rasulullah and to those who before Rasulullah, that if you commit any shirk, no any good deeds will be accepted. No any other good deeds will be accepted. For that pure heart need pure from shirk. Purity number one from shirk. Tawheed, Islamic monotheism, Iman. Remember when I said the heart, according to whatever you fill it. Fill it with Iman, fill it with Tawheed, fill it with love of Allah, better than fill it with shirk, and fill it with bid'ah, and fill it with all kind of haram. والإيمان قول وعمل واعتقاد. The Iman, it is the place of it is the heart. A lot of the action in Islam, place of it is the heart. Saying and doing an aqidah, faith. Leave that because this is topic, big topic about the shirk. Go to the halaqat of shirk, you will find a lot about it. What else to be having a pure and clean heart? سلامته سليم comes from سلامة. سلامته من البدع. How? باتباع السنة. To be سليم and pure must be following Quran and Sunnah. Far away from any بدع. Where is the proof? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. One of the ahadith out of a lot of ahadith about following the Sunnah and آيات also. واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا. Hold fast with the rope of Allah and never ever be divided. And the saying of Rasulullah, whoever make a new thing in our religion. And very important to know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in the religion. Because sometimes jahil one will say to you, plane is a bid'ah, train is a bid'ah, car is a bid'ah, was not at the time of Rasulullah. This is ignorant. Because the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, whoever create a new thing in religion. Because the religion is complete and perfect. When you put any new thing, you're taking out one of that, of what Allah say or what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. Or that this will not be accepted. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say will be rejected. Will be rejected. And Rasulullah himself, when he sitting, hadith in Bukhari, volume number 3, sitting in the hawm and taking a water to give it to the ummah. Some of the people, Rasulullah, the angel will reject them. He will say, they are my ummah, let them come to drink. Because when you drink one time from the river of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will never ever be thirsty after that at all. Let them come. They will say, Ya Rasulullah, you don't know what they did after you. They did not follow your sunnah. For that to have a pure heart, to go to Jannah, to drink from the river of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, follow the sunnah of Rasulullah. In order to follow, you have to know. What else? One of the condition of pure heart, سلامته من الغفلة. غفلة in Arabic, غفلة in Urdu, means to be headless out of the ذكر of Allah. You are not remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not connected to Him. Because your heart, either salim, pure and clean, connected to Allah, and related to the ذكر of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also working with it your tongue, Allah Azza wa Jal say, فاذكروني أذكركم. Remember, I remember you. Mention the name of Allah, Allah will mention your name. In a group better than the group you are in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. قلوب is the plural of قلب. With the ذكر of Allah, your heart will get rested. For that it is. Either you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have also daily routine of doing some of the ذكر of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reading of the Quran or saying of the tasbih or learning some part of the knowledge, connect your heart to Allah. Allah will purify it to you. Allah will make it to you salim. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله عز وجل when you said قال الله عز وجل means it is حديث قدسي.
وطلع سيد قال إن أنا عند ظن عبدي بي. I am with the same thinking of my slave about me. Allah عز وجل saying that. I am means Allah will be for you as the same thinking about Allah. You think about Allah that He can save you, He will save you. You think Allah doesn't know, He will let you with the same way you have. Allah عز وجل say, I will be with the same way you are thinking about Allah. For that we say, حسن الظن بالله عقيدة المسلم. To think good about Allah عز وجل, one of the عقيدة you have to have. Think good about Him. Never blame Allah for anything. For every single thing happened to you or to the community or to the whole ummah, wallahi by Allah there is a wisdom behind it. Allah knows it. Sometimes we'll know, sometimes we'll not know. It looks to us bad, but Allah knows that there is wisdom behind it. Because كل أفعال الله فيها حكمة. All of the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and nothing out of the order of Allah. All of it behind it, there is some wisdom. Either we will know it or we will not know it. For that it is very important to think good about Allah. Never blame Allah. Remember when I said, Ibn Taymiyyah said a very important thing. قال ولو فتشت في صدر كل مسلم, كل مسلم, not only the kafir, كل مسلم, لوجدت في قلبه أو في صدره إما ملامة على الله أو اقتراحا عليه. He said, if you open the chest of any Muslim, either you will find a blame inside himself against Allah or a suggestion. Oh Allah, why it is not like that? Oh Allah, should be like this? Oh Allah, why you have, subhanAllah, or a blaming, وَلَعَازُ بِاللَّهِ. And this is some of the people, they say it clearly, some they don't. When a calamity happened to somebody, oh Allah, why me? This is a blaming. You should not blame Allah. Think good about Him, trust Him, know that He have a wisdom behind everything. Either you know it or you don't know it, then never ever think any bad thinking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at the same time also that you must know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have a wisdom behind everything. For that with whatever thinking you have about Allah, Allah will be for you the same thinking. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ, this is related to our topic, وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. I am with Him when He remember me. Allah will be with you when you remember Him. Remember the Sahabi? He swear by Allah to the Sahaba. قَالَ وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ مَتَى يَذْكُرُنِي رَبِّي. He said, by Allah, I know when Allah remember me. They said, how? He said, doesn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Does not Allah say that remember me or remember you? For that when I remember Allah, I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remember me. فَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِهِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla say, if you remember Allah inside your own self, Allah will remember you inside Himself. وَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَئٍ خَيْرٌ مِنْهُمْ. And if He remember me in a group of people, Allah will remember your name and mention your name in a group better than the group you have. وَإِنْ تَقَرَّبَ مِنِّي شِبْرًا تَقَرَّبْتُ مِنْهُ ذِرَاعًا وَإِنْ تَقَرَّبَ مِنِّي ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ مِنْهُ بَاعًا وَإِنْ أَتَانِي يَمْشِي أَتَيْتُهُ هَرْوَلًا. Allah Azza wa Jalla say that if you come near to Allah only as ba'an, Allah will come to you, nearer to you, an ar means bigger and better. And if you come to Allah nearer one ar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to you nearer a long time, more better than that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, if you come to Allah walking, Allah will come to you running. Look how it is, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرُ رَبَّهُ وَالَّذِي لَا يَذْكُرُ رَبَّهُ مَثَلُ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ. The example of the one who remembers the name of Allah and the example of the one who does not remember the name of Allah is the example of the living person and the dead one. You remember Allah, you are alive. Your heart is alive. You will be connected to Allah. Your heart will be pure and clean, especially if there is no shirk. And the second one, no any kind of bid'ah. The third one, you are connected to Allah by remembering Him. Also, one of the condition of pure heart also, أن يسلم من شهوة تناقض أمر الله وأن يسلم من هوى يناقض الإخلاص. Two things, to save your heart and keep your heart pure and clean, that must be clean your heart from all kind of haram desires. There is halal desires and there is haram desires. Also, there is halal hawa. Hawa means, sometimes it will be misunderstood, but it is the right and the halal. If you target it, this is no problem with it. But when your own bad desire is uncontrolling you, and there is no sincerity to Allah, instead of sincerity, it is show off. Then you don't have a pure heart. Two things in this one: to save yourself from all kind evil and haram and bad desires. Everybody knows what I'm talking about. Any kind of bad desires. Control yourself, then your heart is clean and pure. If you do not, then your heart is not clean and not pure, not salim. Then the second one, make your good deeds and everything you are doing sincerely for Allah, not for show off. If it is show off, your heart is sick. Allah mentioned that in the Quran al-Kareem, that there is some of the heart will be sick. Some of the heart, في قلوبهم مرض. In their heart there is a sickness. فزادهم الله مرضا. Allah increased their sickness if you don't want to clean it. For any kind of sickness, physical sickness, what we do usually? Go to the doctor and take the medicine. Even the medicine we don't like. But because of what? Because we know Allah will give shifa and be careful. Allah is the one who gives shifa, not the medicine, not the doctor. Allah gives shifa because of that. This is the reason. For that, when you come to know that there is some sickness in your heart and you neglect it, if you know that there is some kind of shirk, you follow some of the bid'ah, you are far away from Allah Azza wa Jalla. You follow the bad desires. You are not sincerely to Allah. Then how you want your heart to be clean? Take care of these things. Allah Azza wa Jalla say to Sayyidina Dawood in Surah Sa'd, ayah number 26. Ya Dawood, inna ja'alnaaka khalifatan fil ard, fahkum bayna nasi bil haqq, wa la tattabi'il hawa. O Dawood, we make you Khalifa on the land, who is a messenger, and judge between the people with the truth. وَلَا تَتَّبِعِ الْهَوَى. Never follow your own lusts. Never follow your own bad desires. Because lusts and bad desires, opposite of the justice, opposite of the fear, opposite of the right. Either this or that. Heart cannot contain both. Cannot contain right and wrong. Cannot contain tawheed and shirk. Cannot contain sunnah and bid'ah. Cannot contain dhikr of Allah and not dhikr of Allah. Impossible. For that Allah say not only to me and you, say to even a messenger. وَلَا تَتَّبِعِ الْهَوَى فَيُضِلَّكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. You follow your own lusts, then you will go far away from the way of Allah. When you are far away from the way of Allah, this will bring all kind of disease in your heart. Your heart will not be salim, will not be clean. In Surah Al-Furqan, ayah number 43, and also in Surah Al-Jasiyah, ayah number 22, Allah Azza wa Jal say, أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَى. Did you see the one who taken his own ilah, his own desire? And instead of worshiping Allah, he worship his own desire. And if he worship Allah Azza wa Jal, he will worship Allah according to his own desire only. You say to him, Allah said, Rasulullah said, he will fight you. Because the heart is closed. The heart is not clean. This is what Allah said. Go and look at it. Surah Al-Furqan, Surah number 25, Ayah number 43. Surah Al-Jasiyah, Surah number 45 also. And it is, or Furqan 25, I'm sorry. Al-Jasiyah 45, Ayah number 22. Allah said, did you see the one who taken his own desire, his own bad and haram desire as his own ilah? He is following his own bad desires more than following Allah Azza wa Jal. Problem in these days that some of us, ask Allah save all of us, say Ameen, they will be doing wrong, thinking that they are doing the best. Allah said that in Surah Al-Kahf. Subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of Surah Al-Kahf, saying that some people will do wrong, thinking that they are doing right. Allah Azza wa Jal confirmed it in Quran Al-Kareem, saying that Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa alayhi sahbihi wa sallam bil akhsarina a'mala alladhina dalla sa'yuhum fi al-hayat ad-dunya. Those who go astray, doing wrong, doing haram, وهم يحسبون أنهم يحسنون صنعا while they are thinking that they are doing the right. We ask Allah save us from being like that, doing the wrong and doing the haram and doing cheating and doing whatever make Allah angry and يعني all kind of wrong at the same time, thinking that, oh, I am angels, I am one of the Sahaba. No. Sahaba themselves, they used to ask each other, أَتَرَى فِيَّ نِفَاقًا. Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, they check each other because they know that the truthfulness in every one of them, saying, did you see any kind of hypocrisy in me? Because in front of Allah, kufr and hypocrisy same. But hypocrisy worse than kafir. The hypocrite one worse than kafir. We ask Allah save our heart from all kind of nifaq. Because the first one, safety from shirk and also safety from nifaq. Safety from hypocrisy. الله عز وجل سيد ان القران الكريم سوره الكهف ايه نمبر 28
ولا تطع من اغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان امره فرطا.
When Allah talking this ayah about the heart, he say never ever follow the one who his heart is hidden from the zikr of Allah. Look to yourself and ask yourself, are you connected to Allah all the time or sometimes and sometimes? Are your heart remembering Allah really as it should be done or not? لا تطع means order for the people. Never ever follow and never obey the one who his heart number one about the ghaflat. His heart is ghafil, is far away. 10 hours for the dunya and 10 minutes for Allah if he did it or she did it. For that Allah said, not follow those people, واتبع هواه. Whoever does not remember Allah, he will follow his desires. He will follow his lusts. And those kind of people have no good heart. قال السلف احذر من الناس صنفين. سلف الصالح أبو بكر عمر عثمان الصحابة التابعين say be careful from the people two kind. صاحب هوى قد فتنه هوى. صاحب هوى the one who have a bad desire and already he is يعني drawn by it. He is already following it blindly. Nothing else for him except whatever his own desire has. Even with the law of Allah. Wallahi by Allah. I heard some of the people saying, I will not follow in religion. Look how dangerous is it. In religion, except whatever my own mind accept. This is his worshipping his own desire. He's worshipping his own mind. He's not worshipping Allah because Islam means submissiveness of your will to the will of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal. This is a real Islam. Not to the will of Allah according to your own will, opposite of it. Otherwise, you are worshipping your hawa. Here the Sahaba saying to us, be careful of the people who they are blindly following their own desire. Where it is in the Quran al-Kareem? In Surah Al-Qasas, Surah number 28, Ayah number 50.
وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ
The most going astray one. Allah Azza wa Jal say, مِمَّنِ اتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ بِغَيْرِ هُدًى مِنَ اللَّهِ Who is going more astray than the one who follows his own desire without any guidance. No any guidance. No book of Allah, no sunnah of Rasulullah only. Also be careful of my back home. With this I face a lot of problems, a lot of people with this way. Anything you say, Allah said, Rasulullah said, oh man, Shaykh, it isn't back home doing so. Ya akhi, back home is not the Islam. Back home is not the Quran. This is what I mean exactly. Back home is not the sunnah. The source of Islam is not back home. Source of Islam, what Allah said, what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, with the proof of it. Otherwise, bringing your baggage and luggage with you, full of all of that, whatever you used to do there, and you want to force others also to do, Allah Azza wa Jal say, the most going astray one, the one who follows in desire. Surah Al-Qasas, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah number 77, Allah Azza wa Jal say,
وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا
First one, Allah talking about personal. Second one, this ayah, Allah saying in groups,
وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا أَهْوَاءَ قَوْمٍ قَدْ ضَلُّوا مِنْ قَبْلِ وَأَضَلُّوا كَثِيرًا وَضَلُّوا عَنْ سَوَاءِ السَّبِيلِ
Three in it. Never ever follow. Which is this ayah talking about أهل الكتاب. But it is also for us. Never ever follow أَهْوَاءَ قَوْمٍ قَدْ ضَلُّوا مِنْ قَبْلِ Never ever follow the desires of the people who already going astray before. And Allah said, وَأَضَلُّوا كَثِيرًا And they let a lot of people to go astray behind them. And this is some of the people they take it as Say, do you know how many millions follow that? I said, yeah, even the whole ummah. Follow it. The original thing for us is what Allah said and what Rasulullah said, not the number. Because this is comes from a lot of people. Saying, do you know, 200 million follow that bid'ah. Yeah, it doesn't mean that 200 billions, not millions, follow that bid'ah makes the bid'ah halal. It's not by the number. For that Allah said, وَأَضَلُّوا كَثِيرًا They already get, lead a lot of people to go astray. وَضَلُّوا عَنْ سَوَاءِ السَّبِيلِ And they are far away from the way of Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأدعو الله وأنتم مؤمنون بالإجابة.
الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Sahaba saying two people don't follow. صاحب هوى the one who follows his own bad desires. قد فتنه هوى he's blindly following it and he already in fitna of it.
وصاحب دنيا قد أعمته دنيا
أنا صاحب دنيا the one who is only worshiping the dunya whole of his life for dunya never ever know anything about anything else except dunya only and it is making him blind became blind from the truth, blind from the Quran of Allah, blind from the Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Same ayah. أفرأيت من اتخذ إلهه هوا وأضله الله على علم. Did you see the one who taking his own desire as his own God? And he's going astray, even he have some knowledge. Because look, you have the knowledge, you have to apply. You have to apply it in your life. Otherwise, what's the benefit of the having the knowledge without even applying it? For that, opposite of the salim heart, القلب القاسي, the hard heart, the one who is like a stone. As Allah says in Quran Kareem, كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة. Some of the heart is like the stone or worse than the stone. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise the stone. قال وإن من الحجارة لما يتفجر منه الأنهار. Some of the stones will come out of the water and so on and so on. So Allah praise the stones. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to warn us against that kind of heart. قلب قاسي وجامد العين محروما من لذة الطاعة. The one who's eye when the heart is hard and not soft and not salim, the eye will be following it. Remember when I said heart is the king, all the organs inside and outside, part of your body is a soldier to the heart. Good heart, good body, good intention, good action. Bad heart, والعياذ بالله, ask Allah save us, say ameen. You will find no tears coming out of when he hear the word of Allah. Not even that. Allah, some of the people, when he see somebody else crying when they hear the word of Allah, they look at them. Why he is crying? Because you don't know. Try to know the word of Allah Azza wa Jal, then you will know. Try to soft your heart, then you will know. Try to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those المحرومون من لذة العبادة. Those who is prevented from the enjoyment of the ibadah. They don't know nothing about the Quran Kareem. They don't know nothing, the sweetness of the iman, the sweetness of astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. Their heart does not get soft. Or that some of the people, their eyes, their tears will never come out. Even they hear the word of Allah, sometimes they will understand it. Some of the people, they say it clear. I don't have any greatness in my heart to Allah. Look, how bad is it? I don't have. How you know even he doesn't say by the action? When the action against Allah in the house of Allah Azza wa Jal, then how? How is that man who have greatness to Allah? Allah Azza wa Jal says that in Quran Kareem, go to Surah Al-An'am, ayah number 91. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. They did not estimate Allah and they did not respect Allah as he should be respected. They did not estimate Allah as he should be estimated. They did not respect Allah as he should be respected. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah save our heart from being like that. The last thing Ibn al-Qayyim said, قَالَ إِذَا أَشْرَقَ الْقَلْبُ بِنُورِ الطَّاعَةِ أَقْبَلَتْ وُفُودِ الْخَيْرَاتِ كُلُّهَا بِأَكْمَلِهَا إِلَيْهِ مِنْ كُلِّ نَاحِيَةِ فينتقل صاحب هذا القلب وهذا النور من طاعة إلى طاعة ومن ظلمة إلى نور ومن باطل إلى حق ومن الشيطان إلى الله عز وجل. He said, if your heart have full of the light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it is salim, pure, this is the place of the light from Allah. Because if it is evil and bad, will never come to you any goodness from anywhere. He said, but if it is full of the light, قلب سليم, أقبلت وفود الخيرات. All kind of خير, of goodness will come to it from everywhere. Then he will move from a ta'ah, from obeying, to another obeying. From wrong to the right. From the darkness to the light. From the falsehood to the truth. From the shaitan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To Allah means at the end of Jannah, inshaAllah. But, وإذا أظلم القلب بظلمة المعاصي أقبلت صحائب البلاء والشر كلها إليه من كل ناحية فينتقل صاحبه من معصية إلى معصية ويصبح كالأعمى الذي يتخبط في الظلام فينتقل من سيء إلى أسوأ والعياذ بالله. He said if it is not the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heart, then there is no any doubt will be the darkness of disobeying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because for the ta'a obeying, there is a light. Little by little, part by part, or والعياذ بالله, disobeying Allah and neglecting that, then it will be one black dot. Then on the ayah, كلا برانا, another one black dot, then the darkness come. When the darkness come to the heart, he said, all kind of evil will come to him. All kind of shayateen and calamities will come from everywhere. Then instead of the first one moving from goodness to whatever better and the best, he will move from every calamity to another calamity. From disobeying Allah to better, to bigger than it. He will become like a blind, which it is in a darkness of blind and in darkness. Hitting everything, doesn't know where he's going. Then he will move from the bad to the worst, from the worst to whatever higher than the worst. وأسك الله save our heart. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم كفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم توفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم، ولا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر، والطف بنا يا مولانا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم، ارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم، ارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية، وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا رب العالمين، واجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهتدين لا ضالين ولا مضلين، واجعلنا وأهالينا وبلادنا وبلاد المسلمين يا حي يا قيوم في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ابسط علينا وعلى بلاد المسلمين بسط الخير والأمن والنور والهدى والإيمان يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا، واشرح لنا صدورنا، واغفر لنا ذنوبنا، وكفر عنا سيئاتنا، وتوفنا مع الأبرار، وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك، وارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية، واجعلنا نأتيك بقلوب سليمة يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم، اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين. اللهم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين، وارحم أموات المسلمين أجمعين. اللهم ارحم أموات المسلمين أجمعين يا حي يا قيوم، وطهر قلوبنا من الغل والحقد والحسد والشرك والبدع يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من الغل والحقد والحسد والشرك والبدع يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم، ارضى عنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى وما في الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. وصلي اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، وجزانا وجزاكم الله خيرا.